everyone. Our guest today is Clarence Brooks, Associate Professor and Director of Dance at Florida Atlantic University, Department of Theater and Dance. So Clarence, just to jump right in here, how are you inspiring the next generation of artists and creators to advance the arts?
From the very beginning, my approach was always to educate the whole person and the whole body. Another thing that I do is I'm trying to declutter the stuff that was there before and bring in some new information, or at least lay it out on a table, the information that I have, and then have them decipher it as any way they can. And then my third one is just cross-pollinate the spaces. Make it queer friendly, make it feminist friendly, make it as able-bodied as possible, get rid of the racism and the homophobia, just declutter the space and bring in as much as possible.
This digital age has undeniably changed the game for dancers, for professors, for choreographers. What positive changes have occurred, in your opinion, in this time?
I like the intimacy of this connection with the students. So I am teaching in a small space that is the space of two yoga mats, and that's where I conduct class is the same way, so that everything we're doing is relatable directly to one another. And it's reminded me of, it's a new game of something old that we use. We had this thing called a VHS that we stuck it into a machine, and you learned off of that little machine. This to me is the same thing as Instagram and TikTok and Facebook. It's just a new way of doing it. So I am finding a new way to relate to it because I've been here in a small space looking at the old TVs.
So Clarence, you're one of the founders of a new dance organization here in Miami, Florida Black Dance Artists. Why did you start this organization now?
You all saw the solo that Demetrius Klein had commissioned in 2018 that had the voice of James Baldwin speaking from 1965, and how this brilliant man prophesied, in a sense, that there would be a Black president. And sure enough, here it is, six decades later, we have it happen with the election of Barack Obama, not once, but twice. So there is a lot that is happening that is positive. But when we sit there and we listen to what Baldwin, and he is still trending with what he has said, we realize there's still a lot that's there. So with the Florida Black Dance Artist Organization, we are hoping to galvanize Black dance artists in the state of Florida to give space where we can commune and talk to one another. When you walk into a space where there's already a lot that's in common with the people, there's barriers, just release. And you're able to immediately connect to people. So that's what we're doing. We're trying to do this with Black artists, specifically for dance artists, because we know dance has been around for a very, very long time, but I still think that we're treated as the, you know, ugly stepchild. And I think that we need other such affinity groups as well.
How would you like to see change happen in our community?
I would like us to see the dance community get more political. But I refer to it as the two P's. There's partisanship and there's participation. The partisanship, that would endanger us. We would endanger our tax exempt status and all. But the participation part of it is something that we do need to engage in. And I think we need to do it collectively. But we need to make sure that we are inoculating dance into all the spaces, arts into all these spaces, you know, in a more global sense. And see if we can increase the way in which legislators, politicians, communities see who and what we are. Otherwise, they're just looking at us as, okay, that's that cute little thing that happens on the side. And I think we need to change up the game here.
Well, Clarence, you are thrilling to listen to. And you certainly make one think. So I appreciate you joining Miami Dance Hub for this conversation.